Hello everyone, welcome to the TechGeek webinar. Thank you for joining the session today. The topic for today's talk is Introduction to NoSQL. It will be a one-hour session with around 40 to 45 minutes for the presentation and the remaining time for the Q&A. So if you have any questions, please send them to us using the questions tab on the GoToWebinar control panel. I am Sukriti, the moderator of this session, and it gives me great pleasure to introduce you to our guest speaker, Pooja Dhumal, Scrum Master from Amdocs. A software professional with 9 years of experience in software development and support, Pooja has majorly worked in the billing domain for telecom giants like AT&T, Rogers, T-Mobile US, and has hands-on experience of technologies like C, COBOL, C++, SQL, Unix, shell scripting. Her current role is Scrum Master and is responsible for committed deliveries of billing solutions to T-Mobile US. So without any further delay, let me introduce you to our guest speaker. Over to you, Pooja.
Thank you. Good evening, everyone. We will now start with the introduction to NoSQL, or sometimes it's called as NoSQL. So this is the high-level agenda for today. So we'll go over the brief history of databases, what exactly is NoSQL, and when and where to use it, certain characteristics of NoSQL. There's a very popular theorem called as CAP theorem, and also the different types of NoSQL DBs. So as most of us know this, that a database is an organized collection of data, and a DBMS, that is a database management system, is a software system that controls the creation and maintenance of the data. So this diagram basically represents a brief history of all the number of databases that have evolved. So around 1970, E.F. Codd had introduced the relational model of database. After that, IBM's R, Oracle, Postgres, the Sybase. And you can see that towards the early 2000s, with the presentation of the Bigtable paper and the Dynamo paper, more and more NoSQL databases have come into picture. So what are relational databases and its benefits? In a relational database, the data is organized into relations, or popularly known as tables. It is designed for all purposes. It basically follows asset properties, which is atomicity, consistency, isolation, and durability. So what does atomicity mean? It means that the entire transaction takes place or nothing at all happens. For example, if amount is to be transferred from account A to account B, it will be first deducted from account A and then transferred to B. So either the deduction and the transfer will happen or none of it will happen. Consistency means that the condition of the database before and after the transaction remains same. That is, the data is consistent. Isolation says that multiple operations can be performed independently of each other. And what does durability say? That once a transaction is completed, committed, and written to the disk, it is still there even if the system crashes. So relational databases provide strong consistency, concurrency, and recovery. They use the standard query language, that is SQL or known as SQL, to query and maintain the database. And one of the biggest advantages of relational databases are that a lot of reporting tools can be used. Towards the right, you can see a simple relational database which has the details of customer and its address. So now these information are stored in three different tables or relations. So the customer table has information about the customer, which could be customer ID, first name, address ID, and the creation date. The address table has the details of the address. And using the city ID, you can go to the details of the city via the city table. The examples of SQL databases are Oracle, Microsoft SQL Server, etc. So before going to NoSQL, let us see what is the rise of big data. Now, big data is characterized by three things. Volume, that is the quantity of the data that is generated and processed. Velocity is the speed at which the data is generated and processed, and the variety. So traditionally, the data used to be like consistent. For example, the ERP system, which could have basic details like purchase detail, purchase record, payment record, etc. Now, with increasing time, data could be anything. It could be text, it could be image, it could be audio, or it could be a video. And the figure actually shows the increasing data variety and complexity and the huge rise in big data. The Cambrian explosion of data actually shows how the unstructured data is rising over the years. Certain statistics say that Walmart has more than 1 million transactions per day, and Facebook stores almost 40 billion photos. So the amount of data has now gone to petabytes. So why does the need for NoSQL derive? As we can see, there is a rise in big data. The connectivity across the globe is increasing. Each one of us is connected to either any social media or some platform. There is increasing use of distributed system which require concurrency, and there are a lot of applications running on cloud. This graph of performance versus data complexity shows the RDBMS performance. Now, the relational database management system works very well in performance with structured data. For example, a salary list. But with increasing data complexity, such as most of the web apps, the social networks, and the location-based services, the RDBMS performance goes down. So what is NoSQL? By definition, a NoSQL, originally referring to non-SQL or non-relational database, is a database management system for storage and retrieval of data in form other than the relational or the tabular way. It is increasingly used in real-time web apps and big data. They are also sometimes called as not only SQL to emphasize that they may support SQL-like query languages. Most NoSQLs provide relaxation of one or more asset properties, and they do follow base, which is basically available, soft state, eventually consistent. So what does this mean? Basically available means the read and write functionality is basically available. But it might happen that the read information that we are viewing is not the latest write. Soft state means that the data will not necessarily be consistent. And what does eventually consistent means? That if there is no change to the system for a certain amount of time, then eventually all the data will be consistent. The slide shows the comparison of SQL and NoSQL. So SQL works well with relational database system. NoSQL DBs work well with the non-relational or distributed data systems. SQLs have fixed schema. That is, when you define a table, you need to know what all columns will be there, what will be the data type of each column. NoSQLs do not have a fixed schema. SQL DBs are not suitable for hierarchical data storage, whereas NoSQL are best suited for hierarchical data storage. SQL is best suited for complex queries, as we can perform join on multiple tables and form complex queries to return the required data. NoSQL is not that good for complex queries. SQL provides strong consistency because it follows ACID. NoSQL provides something called as eventual consistency. SQL databases are vertically scalable, whereas the NoSQL are horizontally scalable. SQL follows the ACID properties, and there are many NoSQL databases which follow Base. So when and when not to use NoSQL? When we require to store data which requires a flexible schema, that is, for example, not all rows will have values for all the columns of the data. When the ACID properties of a database are not really needed, when data is being locked from distributed systems, and it is very largely used for storage of temporary data, such as data of a session, shopping cart, or wish list. But NoSQL is not suited where strict ACID compliance is required, at places where financial data needs to be stored, because financial data has to be highly consistent, and also where business critical data needs to be stored, NoSQL is not recommended. Characteristics of NoSQL. So what NoSQL provides is the capability to process both unstructured and semi-structured data. That is, it could be text, image, audio, video. It supports flexible schema. It has higher scalability and cluster friendly. NoSQL is largely used for large volumes of data. What does NoSQL avoids is the overhead of ACID transactions, the complexity of SQL query, and you don't necessarily have to define the schema at the beginning, and DBA presence might not be required. Base over ACID. So ACID provides strong consistency, less availability. If the system goes down, the data will not be available. It provides pessimistic concurrency. What is pessimistic concurrency is, to update a particular record, that record will have to be locked. So no other transaction can actually update that record. And ACID provides complex queries. For Base, availability is the most important thing. It provides weaker consistency or eventual consistency. It is simple and fast to implement, and it provides optimistic concurrency. This slide gives an example of eventual consistency. For example, there are three nodes in this cluster. One node is at Mumbai, the other is at London, and the third is at Boston. So if a user, Pramod, is booking a hotel at the Mumbai node, from say any website, and suppose the update is processed by the node at Boston, but it is not yet processed by the node at London. So Martin will see the room as available, whereas Cindy sees that the room is booked. So the read of Martin and Cindy are actually inconsistent. But if there is no change to the system, over a certain amount of time, both of them will see that the room is booked. So this is eventual consistency. Moving on to the CAP theorem. So the CAP theorem says that at any point, a NoSQL DB can provide only two of the three characteristics. First is consistency. All clients see the same data at the same time, no matter which node they connect to. There are many levels of consistency, like RDBMS follows strict consistency, Cassandra follows tunable consistency, and MongoDB follows eventual consistency. Availability. Any client making a request for data gets a response even if one or more nodes of the cluster are down. Partition tolerance means that the cluster must continue to work despite any number of communication breakdowns between the nodes in the system. So this slide shows a few DBs which fall into certain categories of the CAP theorem. So for example, RDBMS provides consistency and availability. MongoDB H-based Redis provide consistency and partition tolerance. And the DBs such as CouchDB, Cassandra, Amazon's DynamoDB, React, etc. fall under availability and partition tolerance. This slide again shows a number of DBs and which one to choose based on what exactly is the requirement of the system. So what is schemaless data model? In relational database, we have to define the schema at the beginning. That is, we need to define what all tables will be there in the database. We need to define all the columns and the data type for each column. So one cannot add a record which does not fit in the system. And if there is no data in a particular column, a null will still be stored. We need to consider the data types. That is, we cannot add a string to an integer field, etc. And we cannot add multiple items in one single field. So for that, we might have to introduce another system of tables and establish relation between those tables. So NoSQL databases are popularly known as schema-less data models. So there is no predefined schema. There is no unused cell. There is no implicit data type, and most of the considerations are done in application layer. All the items of the data are actually gathered in an aggregate or a document. What is aggregation? Aggregation actually comes from the book Domain Driven Design by Evan. It emphasizes on shared nothing architecture. Shared nothing architecture means that there are independent components in the cluster which have their own memory, processor, and storage. An aggregate is a cluster of domain objects that can be treated as a single unit. These data models are used when you need to store or retrieve the entire aggregate together. The aggregate mechanism reduces the join operations to a minimal level. To understand aggregation in a more familiar way, we can simply see this example. For example, there is an order detail. So it has an order ID, customer, the line items that are purchased, and the payment details. So in order to store this data in a relational database models, we would introduce an order table to have details of the order, then a customer table to have the details of the customer, a third table order lines for the line items, and the fourth table to hold the payment details. Now, if I have to pull all the data of a particular order along with line items, I will have to perform a join on all the tables. Instead, in aggregation, the entire order is stored together. That is the ID, the customer details like first name, last name, all the line items, the payment details can be stored as one single aggregate in the database. This aggregate does not have to have a fixed schema. For some, address information could also be there, whereas it is fine if for others it is missing. Now let us see the major data models of NoSQL DBs. There are four major models. One is the key value store, column family store, Document Store, and GraphDB. The key value database stores the data in the form of simple key value lookups, which use a simple hash function that stores the value mapped to a key into a hash table. In column family, each key is associated with many attributes, that is many columns. And it stores in hybrid row column stores, which are different from the pure relational column stores. The document store is a semi-structured document which can store the data in JSON format, for example. It uses MapReduce based materialization for sorting, aggregation, etc. The fourth is the GraphDB, which uses graph structures for semantic queries with nodes, edges, and properties to represent and store the data. Let us look at the key value store. It is the simplest NoSQL DB, and it is similar to the document model as it provides the flexibility in schema. The data in key value store is not structured using a markup language. The main idea is the use of a hash table. So a simple hash function could be used to map the key and value, and we can simply fetch the entire data based on the key. The data can have any format. The basic operations could be insert the data, update, fetch, delete. And the data is stored entirely as an opaque object, or the value you can say is stored as a binary large object called as blob. The application is responsible for understanding this data. The example where this kind of database can be used is bestseller lists, shopping carts, customer preferences, session management, etc. Some of the examples of key value store are Oracle NoSQL DB, Redis, Voldemort, and Amazon Dynamo. This is a simple diagram which shows how a key value database can be stored. So as you can see, the product ID and the type form the primary key, and the value does not necessarily have a fixed schema. The schema is defined per item. The second type of NoSQL DB is the column family. So it allows you to store the data with keys mapped to values, and the values can be grouped together. So a column database is well suited for data where the writes are uncommon. And an application needs to fetch columns of many rows at a single time. These work well for event logging, content management. Apache Cassandra is one of the top NoSQL column family databases, and it is designed to be used by online applications that require fast performance with no downtime. It provides higher availability without a single point of failure. That is, even if certain nodes in the cluster go down, the data can still be accessible. Some of the examples of column family are Cassandra and HBase. The Cassandra DB was developed at Facebook for the inbox search. It is based on Google's Bigtable and Amazon Dynamo paper. In this kind of data model, every node is aware of all other nodes in the cluster. The design goals are high availability, eventual consistency, incremental scalability, and optimistic replication. Towards the right, we see a simple image of a column family database. So as you can see, the first name, last name, and the date of birth form the personal data, and the job category, salary, etc. from the professional data. So these type of databases can be used if the data for certain columns of all the rows is to be fetched at once. The diagram shows a read operation using the Cassandra DB. So for many NoSQL databases, there is a concept of replication. That is, the data stored at one node of the cluster is also replicated at certain number of nodes. So for example, the data which is at one is also replicated at node 2, 3, and 4. So for example, if the client performs a read request on node 1. And if node 1 goes down, then the request can be fetched from either of the replica. And the read operation can succeed and return the data back to the user. Now the reads can be either single user reads or quorum reads. So for example, if the request goes from 1 to 2, for a single user read, whatever data is returned by 2 will be returned to the client. Quorum read is when a node agrees that a certain quorum of the replica should have the same data. For example, if the quorum is 3, then all the replicas 2, 3, and 4 should have the same data. Only then it will be returned. Otherwise, the node will say to the client that the data is not found. There are some statistics about Facebook search using the Cassandra DB. So initially using MySQL, for data greater than 50 GB, the average time taken for writes was about 300 milliseconds, and the average time for reads was about 350 milliseconds. Now, when this search was rewritten using the Cassandra on the same set of the DB, the average time for writes was reduced to 0.12 milliseconds, and the average time of reads was reduced to 15 milliseconds. The document store database. A document store DBMS stores the data at the document level using a simple markup language like JSON or XML. The document store model makes it easy for developers to store and combine data of any structure without giving up on data access and indexing functionality. The schema can be modified dynamically without any downtime. Such type of databases work well for event logging, online shopping, content management, and in-depth analytical processing. One of the leading NoSQL DBMS is MongoDB, which stores data in a binary JSON format. The examples of MongoDB are CouchDB, the examples of document store are CouchDB and MongoDB. This shows a simple example of a document store. So the first image shows the information stored of a person, which has the first name as Peter, last name as Peterson, and his address. The second and third show how the data about a dog is stored, like the type of the dog, name, mood, and birth date. CouchDB stores the data in JSON format. It has MVCC model and there is no locking. There are no joins, so no primary key, foreign key concepts. And the replication is incremental. The next type of database that we will be seeing is the graph database. which uses graph structures for semantic queries with nodes and edges. It is based on the Euler's and graph theory. The data model is nodes and relationship. So the nodes and relationships have properties. Examples are Neo4j, OrientDB, Infinite Graph. They are widely used in highly connected data like social networks, and they use certain pathfinding algorithms. For example, the Dijkstra algorithm. Now, if we see the example, let us suppose that YouTube is stored in SQL. So there will be number of tables. First is the users. Then to store the information of users' channels, there is another table, users underscore channels. There is a third table to store the subscriptions and then the channel details. So the first table has user ID and the name. The second is user ID and channel ID. In user subscription, you store user ID and channel ID. So if we need to fetch the information of all the subscribers for a particular channel, it would need a join on these tables. Instead, if YouTube is implemented in a graph, it will be something like this. So for example, there is a YouTuber David who operates two channels. This Disco Dancing with David, and the second is David's How To channel. Similarly, there are other YouTube users who are operating their own channels. And there's a user named as Alice who has subscribed to David's How To channel and Charles Cooking with Charles channel. So the information is stored in the form of nodes and edges. So I would like to conclude by saying that we cannot say that the NoSQL are replacing the relational databases or the traditional database systems. It all depends on what is the purpose of the DBMS. If the system requires high consistency and availability to store business critical data or financial data, our DBMS is still one of the strongest options. But if there are needs to store big data or the needs of Web 2.0 companies where you have interactive websites, NoSQL can serve a better option. So we can say that pick the right tool for the job, and the combination of multiple database can serve the purpose. That's all that I have for the session today. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Pooja, for the insightful presentation. You may take up the questions now. They're displaying in the questions panel.
Yeah, I can see the questions now. There's a question from Shailja Segal, if I'm pronouncing the name correct. what is difference between scaling horizontally and vertically? Okay, so scaling vertically would mean that certain rows, certain columns you could store on different nodes, but in horizontal scaling, the entire record has to be stored together. So even if there are thousands of columns, all the columns for a particular record will be stored together. There is another question from Archana. What is ACID? So ACID stands for atomicity, consistency, isolation, and durability, as we discussed in the session. So it means that the atomicity needs to be followed. That is, the entire transaction needs to be performed or none of it. Consistency means the situation of the database before the transaction and after the transaction is consistent. Isolation means the multiple operations can be performed independently. And durability of the data means that after performing a particular transaction and committing it to the database and to the disk, the data is still available even after the system crashes. There's a question, what are the free to use NoSQL DB from Manas Dash? Manas, actually, we can search on Google for that right now. I do not really have the information about it. There's a question from Rahul Agarwal. Can you practice NoSQL in out in our personal laptops by downloading any database? Yes, you can. As far as I know, MongoDB is available. So yes, you can practice by downloading it. There's a question from Sai Krishna Agarwal. What is DBA? DBA is database administrator. Basically, he is one who performs the installation or configuration, migration of the database, and is responsible for the troubleshooting of the database if required. There is one question from SB Abrish Aditya. So basically in our DBMS, data are predominantly related to each other, whereas in NoSQL, it is not the case. Am I right? In our DBMS, the data is stored in different tabular forms. And these tables can be related to each other by any referential constraints or foreign key. But we cannot say that in NoSQL it is not related. In NoSQL, what happens is all the related data is stored together in one row itself. For example, there is data related to a student, his ID, the year in which he is, what all sports he plays, and etc. So this entire thing can be stored as one record. Whereas the same in RDBMS can be maintained using different tables, having the ID for the student, the year that the students are in, or the sports that they play. So I hope that answers the question. A question from Naveen Reddy. What is the exact difference between SQL and MySQL? So SQL is structured query language. It is a language that is used to query a relational database management system, whereas MySQL is a relational database management system. So MySQL server is the DB and SQL is your structured query language. So you could simply say that select star from this table. So this is the structured query language queries. So one is a database and one is the language used to access the database. There's a question from Shanmuga Priya. Which one is best, SQL or NoSQL? It actually depends on the purpose for which we are using the database. So if we do not really need the ACID compliance, we don't need very strong consistency of data, and we need to store a very large amount of data. So this is the situation where NoSQL DBs can be primarily used. Whereas if there is business critical or financial data, this RDBMS, that is relational database management system, can be used. So SQL is not a DB, but it is a query language to query the relational database management systems. What are the limitations of NoSQL? This question is by Azmat Mohammed. So the biggest limitation I can say is the lack of data consistency. So that's why it is used in systems where high consistency is not really required. Because when ACID compliance or high consistency is required, RDBMS is the best solution. So if it is a social networking website or say Facebook or Instagram, and say I have posted an update, for me it does not matter if one of my friend in Pune sees the data first and one of my friend on the other side of the globe sees it sometime later. So when very high consistency of data is not really required, that is when the NoSQL is preferably used. Which is the most popular NoSQL DB? There are a number of popular NoSQL DBs which are used. Cassandra, MongoDB, and Amazon Dynamo are the most popular ones that I have come across.
Pooja, we are like about to, you know, closing there. We're going near to the end of the webinar. So how many questions would you want to take up?
I will try to take up a few. There are some repetitive, so I'm trying to filter.
Because we have, you know, people who are still posting their questions.
What will be your suggestion for finally a student to focus on SQL or non-SQL? I would say both are important. I cannot really comment that one is important and one is not, because each one of it has its own characteristics and each one serves a different purpose. So nowhere we are saying that NoSQL will be replacing the relational database management systems. So yes, both are equally important is what I feel. What is Cassandra quorum? Quorum basically means that a minimum number of people should agree to a particular decision, right? The Google meaning of it. So in Cassandra, where the data is replicated on multiple nodes, it can be decided previously that how many nodes should agree to the same data. So if the quorum is defined as two, then two nodes should return the same data. Only then it will be returned to the client asking for it. So even if the two nodes are not returning, then the reply will be that no data found. So this is how the Cassandra quorum works. I think that's it from my side.
Thank you so much, Pooja, for this really empowering and motivating session today. I would also like to thank all our participants for making this webinar a great success. The session has been recorded, and the recording will soon be available on techgeek.com. Thank you, everyone, for joining us.